Hey everyone, this is Mr. Everything, and today I wanted to do a review on this headset. I believe that this is the best overall gaming headset that you can get that hits all the boxes. Price-wise, it's fairly affordable, great comfort, good sound, amazing compatibility, works well, has everything that I'm looking for. If you can't guess, it's a SteelSeries. But it's a specific model. It's the, I think it's Arctis is how it's pronounced, 7X. Not the 7, not 7P, not the 9 or whatever. It's specifically the 7X is the one that you need for this expanded compatibility to work with pretty much all the consoles and a lot of versatility, anything USB Type-C. So the reason I got these is actually for the last generation of consoles, I've never been a wireless guy. Because I remember back in the day, you had to have like the RCA in the back of the Xbox 360. It was a little more convoluted. So last gen, since you could just plug directly into your controller, I just went with a standard PC gaming headset. This is the HP Omen. Since both PS4 and Xbox One plug into your controller, I would just use it so you could use it on either platform and just being a regular 3.5 mil jack, it will work with anything. These are really comfortable. The only problem I had with these is this started to flake off, so I got tired of it always being on my ears, so I had to spend forever trying to peel all that off, but I still couldn't get it here because it's still pretty well stuck there. It's, you know, not a high traffic area. So these were good. They're still good. They still sound good. They're still comfortable, but to me, these are old school now. This is completely replaced them in all fronts. How I ended up with these is when I got the Xbox Series X, I just decided, since it kind of like rejuvenated my gaming kick, that I would get the new Microsoft headset, the wireless one, and I actually made a video on it where I didn't like that the way the volume was adjusted. It just didn't seem completely right. You would turn it and it would just be completely unresponsive till maybe halfway through the travel, and it would jump way too much on screen. I demonstrated that in the video. I never could really find out if it was that one or if it was all of them worked like that. I think maybe 1,000 people watched that video, and a good dozen or so said they had the same problem. But to me, that's still not enough. Is it just that there's a small amount that have that problem, or is every single one out there like that? So that, and the fact that it was pretty tight and it had the leatherette ear cups and it was pretty tight on the ear, definitely got hot and sticky, and I just didn't like the fit. So I was like, well, maybe I can just exchange it for another pair, see if those have the volume problem, and then maybe buy an upgrade to like a mesh cup like this. And then I just saw for $150, so $50 more, you could get these. And then about the compatibility, which is much better, the Microsoft set was Bluetooth. This is 2.4 gigahertz. But went with these and just everything's so much better. And I'm really glad I switched to these. Now, I bought this specific headset from Walmart. That's a great way. You could do this probably the same with Amazon of returns, but it's gonna take longer. To where I like Walmart, they have good return policy. So if you get one and you don't like it, technically, I mean, you could say it's defective. If it doesn't, if it's not comfortable, if it doesn't sound as good, or like me, like it didn't seem like the volume wheel worked correctly, or what I would find to be correctly for a $99 product. So I exchanged them, got these, and didn't have to do anything else. These completely satisfy what I was looking for. I believe they're actually $139 now at Walmart, so they're a little cheaper. But you can see they're 2.4 gigahertz. 24-hour battery life, I'd say it's at least that. See, about it has a good microphone. And if you really want to delve into this anymore, you can just look it up or watch some, you know, more specific reviews about people that review these. But I like with this, you can get the cushions. If those, like the HP ones, I couldn't find replacement cushions for it. Maybe a third party could maybe rig up to work on it, but these are sold in-house, so they have it. You can go velour, leather, the mesh, the air weave. You can get replacement band, the transmitter, that just it comes, you can get anything you need, and it's all relatively well priced. And you can see the compatibility, Xbox, PC, PlayStation, Nintendo Switch, and then Android or iPad, anything that uses USB-C, you can hook it up to 40 millimeter drivers, some info about the microphone and the battery life and the range. It's excellent. Now, I know there are other people that all they do is review gaming headsets and headphones. They're really going to be picky about stuff. To me, I'm just coming at this like almost budget-minded, but just for the bang for your buck. I want something that sounds good. I definitely don't want something that's not good. But really, overall, just the fact that it can do everything I would need it to do makes this perfect for me. And again, it's just specifically this one. The PlayStation ones, I don't think the P7P, I don't think they would work with Xbox. And then some other ones that are Xbox but Bluetooth, then I don't think you can use them on PlayStation. Or if you can, you can't use them with other devices that would that you can just hook this dongle up to. So this one has the most versatility. But I think first and foremost, the comfort that matters to me. I don't want one that your ear sits on the cup. I like to fit in the cup, and it's kind of weird. But this one, since it has this mesh, they don't heat up on the ear. They don't make your ears sweat. They have good cushion. It has to be a memory foam. It feels like it is anyway. So they're never going to peel because they don't have that leatherette. There is some, like, way down at the bottom. Maybe it would help with some noise cancellation. They aren't marked, though. A lot of them have the... So, with this, they're marked here. So it's in a really hard-to-see spot, but I always just memorize which side has the controls on it. So with this one, it's the left. There's controls on both, but I usually go for either the mic or whatever one has more controls is the one I memorize. I don't like ones that the band itself rests on your head. I like when you have like this tension takes all the pressure off, and I'd rather have that pushing on my head than the band. But it is a metal band, so you're going to have a ton of rigidity and flexibility without any compromising on durability. Those are my bars for the night. I like this. I didn't need to adjust this, but you can. And if it would wear out, you can replace it. Or you could, if you wanted to be picky, you could get the PC one that's just like black, or the PS4 or 5, whatever model that has this in blue if you wanted to waste money just to customize it. But it's really a great build quality. The only problems I've seen with some reviews was that it's like a metal prong or something that goes into this cup. Same with both sides. And some people were showing that it would crack and then it would fall out. If it would happen to me, I could probably JB weld it. But I don't damage my thing. So if it broke for me, then it would be a problem. But I don't see this happening. Most of your movement here is this part, and that's just enough for just getting that extra little bit of dialing in on the head. Aside from that, you shouldn't be putting that much tension. When I'm putting them on, you might be rotating it there a little bit, but I don't see them breaking for me. They haven't, and they use this design on a lot of their headsets, so you would think that it should work if they that's their go-to.
Now, I like the layout of the controls for this. This is the mic mute. I really wish they would have made this a little more tactile. It's pretty hard to know if you clicked it in, and you can hardly see that red. Now, I don't have it on, but this will light up red when it's not in use. So when it is on, there's no light, which I would kind of prefer it to be a light when it's on and then no light when it's muted. But and it's, I love how it's retractable. That's one of the things I liked with the HP Omens. That way you don't have to worry about keeping it with you, keeping it unplugged, but keeping it with you if you want to take it somewhere. So it's always connected, but it's always out of the way if you want it to be. Two-way, so you have that noise cancellation. And I guess that would be your one that picks up your voice more so. good bit of flexibility. I mean, I don't think it's going to stay perfect, especially if you want to retract it back in, but it's pretty good. That's you can bias it toward game chat or in-game sound. Power button, I assume that's the IR, or the antenna for the 2.4, I should say. That's your volume. Main problem, I don't like that it is a micro USB for charging. Micro USB is a little bit tighter of a connection. I could definitely see that getting pushed in and broken if you're not careful. I believe that's to share audio, but you could hook up a 3.5 millimeter, and I think you could go in with it, but I think it's made to send this wired to another device. But I think people have said you still could plug it in that way. How you're supposed to do it is with this included cable, but which is proprietary, which is dumb to me. If you wanted to use it wired, which that's really hard to hook up, now you can use it wired like a regular old school headset. I've never done it that way. That's why I bought a wireless one. It's a tight connection. I could see that going bad, but I don't see too many people buying a wireless headset are going to use it wired. As for charging, you could use any micro USB, but again, I think Type-C would have been better, especially since they offered this in Type-C, I believe, for other models. You could use any cable, and then this will flash red while it's charging. It takes a good while to charge, but that battery life has to be at least 24 hours. I know I can get several long gaming sessions before it'll even say that it's bring up the charging notification, so it's definitely at least that, and that's plenty for me. So hardcore gaming, I'm probably not charging it more than once or twice a week. Otherwise, it could be months in between, because I don't always play with just headset, but when I am, like, you get plenty of use to where I don't mind having to charge it. Now, in terms of connectivity, this is the, you have to use this unless you want to go in wired. There's no Bluetooth in this, and it won't just pick up anything. It will only connect to this receiver wirelessly. So it has a switch. It's only for Xbox. So if you want to use PlayStation, Switch, iPad, anything else, it goes to the USB side. It's white, and then Xbox is green. And being C, you could put it in either way. But this really is the best part about it. It's pretty big for a dongle. And what I did, I have a PS5 now, so I can go straight into the C. But when I had PS4, to use this and test this on the PS4, you can use the included adapter, but I have that cable managed into my Xbox. You can get one of these converters. And it sticks out a good bit, but that's how I could go into the port on my USB port on my PS4. And you could do this on the PS5, but you also have the native C. So that's how I do it on there. And you can use it with all those different consoles. So this is the setup I'm going with the Xbox. Now, this is mainly what I bought it for. So this is the included adapter that's USB Type-A, since the Series X doesn't offer a USB-C. And I don't want to use the front port. I use the rear port with the extension to the adapter that's Type-C. And I have this all just cable managed under my entertainment stand. I set this to the Xbox mode. And if I can do this through the viewfinder, then it's kind of just like right there out of the way. And then it's set and ready to go for any Xbox use. Now, again, you could use that adapter, this one, or that small one I showed to go into this one, but I like what I set up with here. And then it's pretty similar with the PlayStation, at least with the PS5. Switch over to USB. Again, you could use the adapter to go into that, but I like to go into this. And then you're set up for headphones. Everything works.
I don't know if the game chat thing works, but you can adjust that with the in the internal PS5 settings. But the microphone works and the muting and all of that, and it sounds to me just as good as on the Xbox. But the problem is it does block that port, so that's kind of an annoyance. But since I mostly bought this for Xbox, and the fact that I can still use it on the PlayStation and just have to plug that in, doesn't bother me a bit. And then I don't have a Switch to show this with, and I would assume same thing of PC if you had to Type-C, or again, you can just use that adapter to go into Type-A. But I have an iPad Pro, which uses Type-C. So I use my AirPods, but you could do this. And you can see it does recognize. And now this shows up for the headphones or the headset. And you can use it with your headset again. I would assume that the mic works, but I would never have a use to use the mic on my iPad. But as far as audio through the headset, works just fine. If I wanted to go over the ear, maybe I wanted to watch a concert on here or something, and I wanted something a little more immersive than the AirPods, I could do that. So it's a nice option. So being prioritized for the Xbox, it feature-wise is best on the Xbox. And if I didn't, like, this is a TCL TV, it doesn't have Bluetooth built in. If it did have Bluetooth, I would probably just use a regular Bluetooth wireless headset. Using a headset, I really don't do that much. I mostly just want it for quieter and more precise audio. But if I go ahead and turn it on, you get the headset pop up. And so there's adjustments here, but then if I adjust this, that's the bias one. And then the volume's independent of this one. So you could move things around a little bit in terms of dialing that in. And then I also have the Dolby app, which I didn't notice that much of a difference. It might be worth, I believe that I already used it. You can see I'd used that trial, but I'm not exactly sure what all games supported it. It sounds fine to me the way it is. You can also hook this up to your PC, which I did with my Microsoft Surface, and you can install the editing for the equalizer and such. And I set it to how I like. That's something probably from people that are more into audio. It sounds good to me, but this does support the Dolby Atmos, so it's just a nice feature set, really. And then if I switch over to the PS5, again, you take that dongle and you switch it to the USB slider, and then it works with this headset again. The only thing I don't like is you could have the headset turned off, but still have that dongle in, and it'll still mute the audio. So the Xbox is a little bit more intelligent. Even with the dongle in, it'll know if the headset's not connected to it, to where this, you have to physically unplug it from the console to get the audio to play back through your TV. So that's a little bit more of an inconvenience. But again, to me, it doesn't bother me. For $150, the fact that I can use it on both consoles, have the added bonus of iPad, or if I did want to use anything else, or if I had a Switch, which I don't, but it checks all the boxes. I highly recommend it. I think it's the best headset, and it's pretty well priced with everything you consider getting with it. So hopefully that if you're looking for a headset, that's the one I'd recommend. And if you're only PlayStation or something, then yeah, you could go with the others. But if you look, for my use case, it works well. And I think it could definitely be that perfect one for a lot of other people too. So thanks for watching, and you'll see me in the next one. Have a good one.